Jerusalem, a place that pulses with meaning for millions of people. Being mayor of this city means much more than running public transport and collecting the rubbish. And it's a job that's up for grabs in elections today. It's been a holy city for centuries, and these days it's increasingly becoming a religious city. The outgoing mayor, an ultra-Orthodox Jew, has stamped his mark. Almost all restaurants are kosher, and shops and businesses have to close on the Sabbath. And it's set to continue this way if the leading religious candidate is elected mayor.
It's kind of hard to live as a non-religious person in Jerusalem. And I think that my point of view is coming especially from being 4 years out of Jerusalem.
I always had religious people near me, so I'm used to it. But I see that lots of neighbors around me starting to get religious. And eventually all Jerusalem, you know? And it's scary. It scares me.
It's a trend that the main secular candidate is hoping to change. A right-wing multi-millionaire investor, he's promising to bring new businesses to Jerusalem and to stop the exodus of young people from the city.
But there's one thing the two main candidates agree on. They want to expand the illegal Jewish settlements in East Jerusalem. It's part of a plan to change the character of the city at the expense of its Palestinian residents, many of whom now find themselves living on the other side of the wall.
More than 200,000 Palestinians living in Jerusalem have the right to vote in these elections, but most of them don't want to take part in a poll organized by the occupying power. They hope that one day East Jerusalem will be the capital of a Palestinian state, and that's not on the agenda in this election. Jackie Rowland, Al Jazeera, Jerusalem.